In this screencast, I'm going to discuss how we use an Excel spreadsheet to determine confidence intervals for kinetic parameters. And these kinetic parameters we determine by nonlinear regression when data from a plug flow catalytic reactor. The rate expression is shown here. So the two parameters are K and Ka. And we want to get, first, we've done regression to get values for these two parameters. Now here we want to explain how we get the confidence intervals for these parameters. Previous screencasts have explained the logic behind the calculations and then showed the Excel spreadsheet. So here I just want to concentrate on the part of the Excel spreadsheet where we're obtaining the confidence intervals. So let's look at that spreadsheet. Well, here's the spreadsheet, and this shows the two parameters that we obtained in yellow are the parameters we obtained by nonlinear regression. Original means these are the values we used to generate the experimental, quote, experimental data, and then we added some noise to it. And so you see the regression gets us pretty close to these values. And the question is if we, of course, for real data, we don't know what, quote, original values are. We'd like to know how good the K and Ka values are, what are confidence limits. So I've already explained these terms in the table. What I want to do is move over to the part where we're calculating confidence intervals. Now, we can't do a partial derivative like we'd like to. So you'll notice over here, I have in this cell, I called this column partial derivative of the concentration leaving reactor as a function of Ka. Well, we don't have explicit expression for concentration as a function of Ka, so we're going to generate that, and we're going to likewise generate this partial derivative in order to create this matrix. I'll explain that. And we're going to do it by using the spreadsheet to substitute in values here. So we're going to substitute, for example, a Ka value slightly different, and then look at how CAF changes. So we have a small change in Ka that results in a small change in CAF that we get from solving the differential equation. Divide those small changes, then that is a reasonable approximation to the derivative. So I'm going to divide the delta Ca final over delta Ka. So I copied here just our numerical values that were yellow in these other cells, and I've called them Ka base because now I want to vary around it. And I want to vary by saying I'm going to look at a value delta of Ka base above it and then delta below. So this number is slightly bigger than this one, and then this number is slightly smaller, and I've done the same thing for K. And the delta I've arbitrarily picked to be small enough, hopefully, to give us reasonable results, 0.001. And so then what I've done is I've done four calculations. I've taken the plus delta value, the Ka base times 1 plus delta, so it's 0.09492, and of course there are more significant figures I'm just not displaying. And I've substitute that in here. Well, the calculation then will run to generate new CAA final values for each of the flow rates and put them in the column CA final in this data table. So then what I've done is I've selected the new values. So let me actually pause and show you how I've done that. So I've copied that value 1 plus delta, and then I'm going to paste it here. That redid all the calculations, generated a new table, and then I can select this table because these are different values slightly. I'm going to copy them and I'm going to paste them over here in this column, and these are the values that I paste. But notice when I paste special so that what I've done is paste just the numerical values, not the equations. So I paste the numerical values, then I go back and put the correct value in here again for Ka, and I repeat that procedure with Ka minus, copy those values here, go back, reset Ka again, and then use K rate constant times 1 plus delta, substitute that in, generate a new table, copy those values in here, and so forth for the K minus data column. So now I have a set of values that I can approximate derivatives. So this 116 is the difference between these two CA values, plus delta and minus delta, divided by the delta value times Ka base, because that's how much we actually changed. And it's 2 because we did plus this value and minus this value. So the derivative is the total change in concentration numerator, the change in the Ka base denominator. This gives us an approximation for partial derivatives. So you can see the formula here that we did this. And then likewise for K, similar formula. So now we have partial derivatives. Next thing we did was to label this as a matrix. So that means selecting the cells and going up here and putting the name in. You can see X in the upper left-hand corner. So I've named it matrix X, and I'm going to do that because I'm going to do matrix calculations. You can see that up here we take the transpose of X, multiply by X, matrix multiplication of transpose times X, and then we take the inverse of that. Well, I won't go through an explanation of the reasoning behind this, since it's already going to take a long time to just explain this. But what we've done is first select these four cells because we want to do a matrix calculation. We then type in this formula, and then we do Control Shift Enter, and it generates the matrix. Now we're almost finished. Here we have the sum of the squares. It's this cell, which was the sum of the squares divided by the degrees of freedom, which is number of data points minus number of parameters. And so that degrees of freedom is 9. So SE is the square root of that, and SE squared, just because of the notation, I want to make it clear, that's the square of that value. We then generate SKA by multiplying SE squared by the 1-1 element in the matrix, and SK we generate by multiplying SE squared by the 2-2 element in the matrix. We want 95% confidence limit, so we put 5% here. This is the t-distribution term that we're going to use in the calculation, and I had the degrees of freedom here. So the confidence interval for Ka is this t value multiplied by SKA, and a confidence interval for K is the T value multiplied by this SK. So relatively long calculation for a case where we have to estimate the partial derivatives, but you can see we have confidence intervals. They're certainly not great, but they're at least smaller than the value of the parameters.